motivated.
Get motivated.
Get motivated. Hip hop motivated. Blowing wisdom on the mic with Sean.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, it is time to get motivated. Welcome to a live edition of Flow of Wisdom Radio. I am your host, Sean Anthony. Toll-free number is 1-877-300-7645. The website is flowofwisdom.com. Please log on there and get connected with me through all my social media, flowofwisdom.com. We do the show live every Sunday, 3 to 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And boy, what an eventful week for me. Had a very eventful week watching my oldest son go across that stage and graduating, so proud and ecstatic. Family in and out of town all throughout the week. And then as I'm watching game 6 of the Cleveland Cavaliers versus the Golden State Warriors, a big storm comes through Central Virginia. Tornado warnings and big gust of winds, and boom, power goes out. I was out of power all of the remaining night. What was the game? I was on Thursday night, all day Friday, and thank God power was restored Saturday morning, yesterday morning. And I got to tell you, over 200,000 people in Virginia were without power due to this massive storm that came through and hit us. And I got to tell you, out of all the storms I've been through, you know, been able to live through, my power has never been out at that long, you know, for over a 24-hour period. However, I'm very grateful that I was prepared. I'm very grateful that I was prepared. I had to pick up a couple of extra items like ice, but I had plenty of water, plenty of food, and I had a grill. Thank God the weather was not hot. So, you know, the air conditioner didn't have to be on to keep us cool or anything. We just opened the windows and let that fresh, cool chemtrail breeze come through the house, if you will. but I'm very grateful, you know, that the power has been restored and Dominion has restored, I think, last time I checked, which is a couple hours ago, about 90% of people's power has been restored. So I just hope and pray that everyone else gets their power restored. And, you know, and for those that were not prepared, maybe this could get you in that mindset of being prepared. You know, it was just really, you know, I was not worried at all, not one bit. I wasn't concerned. And I cranked up the grill, you know, so some of the meats that I had at stored, the protein and everything, it did not go to waste. Because one, like I said, I had extra bags of ice to keep everything iced up and cooled and frozen. And I cranked up that grill and was like, you know what, when it rains lemons, you got to make lemonade. And so I was very fortunate for that. And I was not stressed or worried at not one bit. And I kept an even keel. And it really showed a lot about me and how I was prepared for that particular circumstances. But nonetheless, be prepared, guys. Be prepared. And that's something that I'm going to be talking about, preparedness today. But just follow me. All right, I did mention I was watching the game 6 of the NBA Finals, right? And let me just put this on record right now. Game 7 is tonight. And I have never been a Cleveland Cavaliers fan. However, those that know me personally know that I rock with LeBron James. I've been a supporter of him since he was in high school. I was working on the radio when he was making all kind of statewide news and getting lots of attention when he was in high school. He even came and played in Columbus several times. And at the time, I would host parties and throughout the city. His mother would come frequent at some of the events that I've hosted in the past. But, you know, just watching LeBron, you know, being in Ohio at that time, watching him from his young days going into the NBAs, I've just always been a big supporter of LeBron James. I rock with him, and I am rooting for him. And I will put the, I will go ahead and make my, prediction. Cleveland will win tonight. LeBron James, they will make history tonight. And I mean that with all sincerity too, because I just believe that LeBron is the best player. And the guys, they're all on board, and I just really believe that it's going to happen. And also, on the flip side of that, I don't know if you guys have been following this show as of lately. Over the past several months, you know I've been doing a series on CERN, and did a series on the Boule and some other interesting topics. But one of the shows I did not long ago, I talked about the Republican National Convention. And I put out that question then, and I'll reiterate it now. You know, one question is, why is the entire Republican Party mostly divided against Donald Trump? Now, the Republican National Convention is coming up next month now. And I think it was a couple of months ago that I was talking about some of the things that I'm going to reiterate and mention today, because as we get closer to this Republican National Convention, it's all going to make sense, in my opinion. The Republican National Convention next month, just weeks away. And I've been asking the question, well, not so much asking the question. I was letting you know that I had inside information on the heightened security that has gone into this Republican National Convention. And some of my sources were a little bit concerned because, look, for one, you've got all of these political figures and dignitaries flying in from all over the country, maybe even the world, to be at this convention. So one would suspect heightened security at such a large event, especially when you're talking about political issues and political candidates running for president and so on and so forth. So there is a necessary precaution that our government, our public servants need to take, they need to hold in place, you know, to protect and serve, right? But when I get inside word from those that are on the inside, like, man, saying, I don't know, I've never seen this type of preparation before, it makes me, you know, one on the outside looking in, just a little curious, a little bit more curious. So anyway, so we're going to talk about that today and really look at some of the information now that is starting to come out over the past month and a half about the security measures and things that are going on. And out of the articles that I've read so far, none of them have talked about some of the things that I brought up on my show, about a month ago, talking about this, which we'll get into, as far as the training pertaining to radiological preparedness, especially, being led by FEMA. So we'll get into that, opening up the phone lines as well for your commentary, your thoughts on this. I know I have some listeners in Ohio as well, people that are listening online at gcnlive.com. Please feel free to chime in. Please feel free to chime in, because this is crunch time now. The city of Cleveland just got approved last year, towards the end of last year, to receive a significant amount of money to prepare for this Republican National Convention. And not only that, there's going to be a series of big events that's going to take place all throughout July. I remember I was talking to Robert X about a month ago on this subject, and I told him, I said, I believe that Cleveland's number one, they're going to go to the finals. This was before they made it to the NBA finals. I said, I believe Cleveland's going to go to the finals, not just because I rock with LeBron James. I'm rooting for LeBron James. And on top of that, because of the insight I was getting on this Republican National Convention, Cleveland will win the title. The parades will be, held downtown Cleveland. The city will be rejoicing. And then you got the National Convention that's coming up. So just doing a little digging. And he agreed. He thought for more similar reasons as well, that there just seems to be a link around the city of Cleveland with these big events that's going down. So what is it with Cleveland? What's going on with Cleveland? Why is this, all of this attention going into the city of Cleveland? That's one of the reasons what leads me to believe that Cleveland's going to win the NBA Finals tonight, in addition to LeBron James' skills. But some interesting articles coming out. The TSA is ready and prepared. Cleveland.com is talking about when visitors pouring into Cleveland in July for the Republican National Convention, they're going to be met by a security plan nearly a year in the works. And I've got privy to this earlier this year, and it wasn't until about a month and a half ago is when I first spoke about it on the show. So they've been planning for this for a long time. And these articles coming out confirms with information that I've been told personally. But like I said, some of these articles don't dive deep in some of the things that they're also being trained for that I was privy to. And we're going to get into that. 877-300-7645. I'm Sean Anthony. You're listening to Flow of Wisdom. All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Flow of Wisdom Radio. I'm your host, Sean Anthony. Toll free, 877-300-7645. We have Mark from Missouri on the line, wants to talk about scripture. Mark from Missouri, welcome to Flow of Wisdom. How are you?
Oh, good. Thank you. Thank you, Sean, for your program. I've got some scripture. I don't have an opinion, but I've got some scripture that I'd like to share. And if you look at 2 Samuel chapter 15 and 16, it talks about a plot that Absalom went into his father's concubines, and out of this came a conspiracy. And this man who was David's counselor, Ahithophel, he had a grudge against King David, and it was secret. And it wasn't revealed until all this happened with Absalom, that he actually conformed this conspiracy against King David to destroy him. And I think there's a conspiracy that you've talked about in your programs that is going on behind the scenes, and I believe it involves what we refer to as Esau, Edom, and the Amalekites, and these people that call themselves Israel and lie and are not. Are you're familiar with that?
With it, repeat that last statement, what you just said about Israel.
Well, there's these people it refers to in the synagogue as the synagogue of Satan, those who call themselves Israel.
Right. Revelations 2:9.
Yeah. And I don't really like to use the word Jews because Jews refers to Judea or being born in Judea, but there's this. I think we're going to see a conspiracy, and this conspiracy that it talks about in 2 Samuel that came out during David's time, he didn't know that this man who was close to him, that was his counselor, well, actually was betraying him, right, and forming a plot against him. And I think we see a plot being formed against Christians, because if you go back, and there's a show on a woman, she doesn't do biblical teaching, but she does current events, and her name is Erin Dakins, and she had an interview on there of a woman whose husband was a senator, and he talked about that the Jews here in America passed a law to, they actually, it's a law to kill Christians. where it gives them the legal right to kill Christians. Mm. And I just want to, you know, encourage you to email her, and, you know, and she could probably direct you to that program. But there is conspiracy. But, you know, isn't it interesting that there that there's a model of Jerusalem and the temple down there in Florida, right?
Oh, yeah. The TBN, I think, the Christian Broadcast Network put a bunch of money into there and created the whole Jerusalem scenery, right? Is that what you're referring to?
Yeah, that's what I'm referring to. And you know, and this nightclub down there, you know, we know that Sandy Hook was a whole fraud. And I know you like to deal with the facts, but let me just go to the scripture. And if you go back and read the writings of Josephus concerning the Jewish wars that were going on in Jerusalem, that our Lord Jesus Messiah prophesied that would happen, and that these wars were from 66 AD, 67, 68, 69, and 70 AD. And these Jewish wars, it talks about the oracle of the prophets, and it says the day of her fall. And the day of her fall is reference to the slaughter of his fellow countrymen. And, you know, whether these things are, whether this is true or not, what happened in Orlando, because we know what happened in Sandy Hook wasn't, these people have in their heart, they have in their heart a desire to kill. And they have in their heart a desire to destroy the people of this nation. Now, I believe America is the new Jerusalem that goes back to our fathers, that talks about in 2 Samuel chapter 7, verse 10. But the whole chapter talks about where God revealed to King David.
Mark, let me put you on hold real quick. We got to take a quick break because I want to ask you when we come back, who are these people that you are referring to? Answer me right after this quick commercial break. We'll be back with more on Flow of Wisdom Radio. All right. Thank you so much for tuning in. We are now live on 99.3 FM in Chattanooga, Tennessee, as well as 1470 AM in Knoxville, Tennessee, Barstow, California, 1230 AM, and Forks, Washington, 96.7 FM. And those listening on the World Wide Web, GCNLive.com, welcome back to Flow of Wisdom Radio. I am Sean Anthony, toll-free number 877-300-7645. Mark in Missouri on the line. You were sharing various topics, you know, pertaining to the scripture, Absalom, the conspiracy with King David. But you made some comments. You said that Christians are being targeted, and I wanted you to finish to elaborate on what you were saying, Mark. But who are you referring to as far as who's targeting Christians?
Well, there's three classes of people. Today, the modern Khazars are the people over there in Palestine that call themselves Jews that say that they're Israel, and they don't have any bloodline of the Hebrew race or the Israelite race. The Khazars are people that came from Russia, and they converted to Judaism, and they made Judaism their religion, and which is the Babylonian Talmud. The other sect of people would be Esau, Edom, that goes back to the time of the ancient times with Jacob and Esau, and Amalek was a descendant of Esau, Edom. And then the other people would be the Jews during the time of Jesus that rejected the covenant that Jesus brought with the new covenant, and they rejected their belief in Jesus. And that's the three classifications. And you go back to Josephus, called the Jewish Wars, and the Zealots were the ones who committed the abomination of desolation in the temple by shedding the blood, the slaughter of their fellow countrymen, and they shed the blood in the temple, and that was the abomination of desolation. And you go back and you read the words of Josephus, and he says, "I think God had sentenced this polluted city to destruction and willed that the sanctuary should be purged with fire." And then there's other statements where he says, it was God who condemned the whole nation and turned every means of escape to their destruction. So I believe that's where we're at because of these people who have these three classifications as Khazars, Esau, Edom, and the Jews who reject Jesus as Messiah and still do to this day. And the same people that were there during the time of Jesus are there today. And this is what we got going on, a conspiracy to destroy Christianity throughout the entire world.
I got you. So how do you tie this into the heightened security that I was alluding to at the beginning of the show with the Republican National Convention coming up? Do you suspect anything that's going to happen during that time? Tying into what you're saying, this mass of violence and destruction of people and Christians being targeted?
Well, I do want to share with this. I do want to share now, I as a calling, and I say this in humbleness, as the calling that God has called me as a prophet, and I have done the program on a couple of radio stations at times when I had the finances to do it, but I do believe that the destruction, and you talked about a storm, and I do believe that there is a storm that's coming to the entire East Coast. I believe it's coming to the entire East Coast, and it's going to take out the coast. And I believe the judgment that's coming upon our nation, and I do believe that this is the new Jerusalem, the restored Israel that God promised, that God gave to King David in 2 Samuel chapter 7, verse 10, called the appointed land. But we're going to go through a time of judgment, and just like ancient Israel did. And we're going to see, I believe, and I will say, thus saith the Lord, Yahweh, Yesu Elohim, Jesus Messiah, that the East Coast is going to be taken out.
When do you think this is going to happen, Mark?
I believe it's going to happen. I can't give you the exact day or the exact time now, but I believe that what God's revealed to me, because I have traveled the coast before Hurricane Sandy and before the hurricane, and I traveled the coast in 2002 by the Gulf of Mexico, and I prophesied to people that there would be a hurricane that would hit the entire Gulf coast of Mexico, and that came about 18 months later after that, after I prophesied it. And I traveled the East Coast in 2004 and 2005, and since that time I've been prophesying that judgment would come upon the entire coast now. But Jeremiah the prophet prophesied over the house of Judah for many, many years about destruction. And, they accused him of being a false prophet because it didn't happen right away, but it did happen, and judgment came upon the house of Judah.
Mm-hmm. What about the West Coast, and down in the Gulf area? There were talks a couple of years ago. I remember on my program we were talking about Puerto Rico. There was people having consistent dreams of a tidal wave hitting Puerto Rico and down there off the southern coast. Is that included in the East Coast? Or are you still pertaining to that being the East Coast?
Well, I can only tell you what God, shows me and what he deals with me. I can't say anything about the West Coast. There's certainly stuff going on with the, as we see with the volcanic activity that's going on, but I can only deal with what God has shown me, and I do believe, and I know you have, I know you mentioned your brother being in Florida, but I have warned a lot of people in Florida to get out of there because the whole place is going to be taken out. The whole state of Florida is going to be underneath the Atlantic Ocean, New York City, all of it's going to go underneath the ocean. That's the judgment, but the judgment that's coming upon this whole land, and it's coming because of these people who have evil in their heart to slaughter people. Now, whether this really happened at this nightclub or not, whether it was just a shell, not real, they still have the intention of wanting to slaughter people, right?
Gotcha. Yeah.
Yeah. And,
all right.
and I know what you're, you know, I've listened to some of your program, and, you know, and clips of different things that you said. And this is what Jesus said. He said, this is exactly what our Lord meant when he declared, these be the days of vengeance, for all things which are written may be fulfilled. And that was Luke chapter 21, 22. And even though that was fulfilled in ancient Jerusalem, it's going to be fulfilled in modern Israel, New Jerusalem, USA.
Gotcha. Okay, Mark, thanks for the call. I got to move on, man. I got some other callers in here. I definitely appreciate you listening and sharing that word. That's Mark in Missouri. Yeah, 877-300-7645. He said quite a few things. Do you guys agree or disagree with what Mark is saying? Do you believe that judgment is coming on our nation? Some would attest to that, that we're seeing it now. You know, Leroy, at the end of the show last week, when we were talking about the whole scenario that transpired in Orlando, Leroy from Atlanta called in at the very end of the show, made some pretty bold statements. Whether it was timely and sensitive or not, you know, that's up for debate. But he basically said, well, if they weren't gay, they wouldn't have been in that club and it wouldn't have happened. And, you know, there were some innocent people that were taken out that were in other places in mass shootings, that weren't fornicating or in living in sin or what have you. But anyway, you know, I wanted to talk about this Republican National Convention. But however, it's good that a phone call can change the direction of the show. What happened to that guy? We just had somebody down in Ohio. Did I hit the wrong button? Oh, it dropped off. Okay. Thank you, Justin, my producer in the studio. Well, Don, if you're able to get reconnected, call back in. I seen him in Ohio, especially somebody in, you know, from Ohio. I would love to hear from you, your perspective and, your insight on things that you may have noticed in the state of Ohio, especially the city in Cleveland and surrounding areas. But nonetheless, I was telling you guys that the heightened security is at an all-time high in the city of Cleveland. And it's not just about the NBA finals, of course, but it's centered around this Republican National Convention. You got some 50,000 people that are expected to visit, including delegates, reporters, and camera crews during a weekend of July 18th through the 21st. In addition to that, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to have lots of protesters. Well, not we, but they will have lots of protesters that are going to infiltrate that these different government entities anticipate. And this is coming from Cleveland.com. They're also talking about most of the visitors are going to be arriving by plane. And when they land, they're going to have to be going through a series of security checks and security booths at the Cleveland airports, the transits, trains, and at the convention venues. Security at Burke Lakefront Airport will be way up, as Cleveland.com reports. The TSA will have officers at all these places screening people through security checkpoints while watching for threats. The planning began 8 months ago and includes local law enforcement, Ohio officials, and U.S. Secret Service. They're all going to be there. There's going to be more officers than usual. And I was told this several months ago that they have never seen, and this was somebody that's from the inside. Like what I'm sharing with you guys, it's not from he said, she said. This is from someone that's on the inside. And as I told you guys this on my show a couple of months ago, I had to be very careful at that particular time because of the information I was getting. I had to be very careful on the information I was given because I didn't want to jeopardize my particular source. But nonetheless, the articles that I found, nothing linked up with one piece of information that I shared with you guys a couple of months ago, and that was the fact that they were training, have been training, maybe still are training, for radiological nuclear WMD operations. I was told that this training is not open to just any and everybody, and you need security numbers and ID, and it comes from FEMA. I'll explain more, plus take your calls from New York and Ohio after this. It's Flow of Wisdom Radio. Lots of money being poured into the city of Cleveland, Ohio, preparing for the Republican National Conventions due to set place in July 17th, 18th, 19th, 18th through the 21st. And I told you there's been training that's been going on for the radiological nuclear WMD operations as well from many of our first responders and law enforcement as well. 877-300-7645. Let's go to John in New York talking about Cleveland. John in New York, welcome to Flow of Wisdom.
Peace. I'd like to say Happy Father's Day to you first and foremost, and congratulations on your son graduating.
Peace. Thank you, man. I appreciate it.
Yeah, and then as far as Cleveland's concerned, I agree with you. They're probably going to win tonight so that, you know, when the city riots, they can do a quick dry run. As far as all the increased security and everything, because, you know, of course, sports are so important that everybody's got a riot. Mm-hmm. And so they'll do a dry run there. And then as far as the Republican convention, like, a lot of the key figures, the so-called neoconservative movement, have already announced that they're not going to be there. So all the security and stuff, I'm just thinking we'll see a false flag. Like, they can't stop Donald Trump from getting in because of his popularity. So, you know what I mean? They've already got the pieces in place to do an inside job, basically.
And when you say inside job, what specifically do you mean?
Well, the higher-ups in the Republican Party have already stated they do not want Donald Trump in.
Right.
So what better way to get him out than to just take him out? Something happens right then and there at the convention. They don't have to name him the nominee because he's either injured or killed. Or, you know, there's such a major event, say riots or whatever, that it just prevents it for the greater good of the people.
Mm-hmm. You know, John, that's interesting you say that. Here's the thing that I really want to put this thought into people that are listening to the show right now. And first, let me put this disclaimer out there. As I've said before, I'm no supporter of Clinton. I'm no supporter of Trump. Okay. However, one must question, at least for me, one must question, why is it that the daggone Republican, the Republicans don't want to see this guy in? That should bring some kind of red flag to, okay, it's one thing, okay, the Democratic Party doesn't want him in, of course, that's obvious, they
right.
want another Democrat in, but you got the Republican Party just throwing a little tizzy fit because of this guy's momentum. Why is it that they don't want him in? And what it is, what I'm learning, John, is that he's going against the grain, the system that's
right.
typically in place. And, you know, whether he's for it or not, whether he is a globalist or not, I don't know. We all know he's a billionaire and global interest, the global economy can certainly benefit him as a businessman. But one's got to ask, why are they against this guy? What is it that they don't want him to reveal?
Right. Well, he's not playing their game. For one thing, he got up there and he didn't have to take any of their money. So he's not bought and paid for like your typical candidate from either side. Mm-hmm. And he, it's like he comes at both sides. You know what I mean? He comes at the Democrats, of course, because he's running as the Republican. But then he comes at the Republicans, too.
Right. Right. Yeah, he's definitely going against the grain, and it's not he's not playing by their rules. And you
right.
hit the nail on the head. Yep.
Like he's a total egomaniac. I will say that. I don't know if that's necessarily a good or a bad thing, but I will say that it probably bothers them that it seems like no matter what, he wants to do what he feels is right for the country from his perspective and not necessarily from the interest of the Republican Party.
Right. Yeah. Hey, John from New York, thanks for calling in, man. First time hearing from you, man. Hopefully you'll continue to listen to the show and feel free to call back at any time.
Absolutely. Great show last week, my man.
Thank you, John. Appreciate it, man, in New York City. Stick on. We have some other callers on the line. I see Don from Ohio called back. Don, I'm going to get to you as soon as we kick off hour two. So just hold tight as we do the news and take this commercial break. We'll be back with more right here on Full Wisdom Radio. Let's get motivated.
Motivated, hip hop motivated, blowing wisdom on the mic with Sean.